Hi there, Grade 7s. Welcome to your English lesson today. I hope you are all well and raring to get going. Remember to have your notebook and a pen at hand for our activities as we work through today's lesson, which is going to be on relative clauses. A quick reminder of our email address. It is grade7@worksheetcloud.com, and that is there for you if you wish to send us any questions or any examples of the work you have been doing here at Worksheet Cloud. We love hearing from you. Okay, so we are going to learn today, as I've already said, about relative clauses. Now, if you haven't yet, it would be beneficial for you to go and watch the video lesson about independent and subordinate clauses, because relative clauses are a form of subordinate clause. So what is a relative clause? Well, a relative clause is used when we want to add additional information or extra detail about a noun into a sentence. Instead of using two simple sentences, such as Sarah is eating roast chicken, it is her favorite meal, we combine those two sentences into making a complex sentence with a relative clause. And as I said earlier, a relative clause is a form of a subordinate clause. In a subordinate clause, if you watch the video I made on that, it tells you a subordinate clause starts with a subordinating conjunction, whereas a relative clause begins with a relative pronoun. So you'll see here in the example above, we've replaced it at the beginning of the second simple sentence. We've put a comma after spaghetti, and we've used the word which, and which is a relative pronoun. Now, if you don't know all your relative pronouns, don't worry, we're going to go over the most common ones in shortly together. So here they are. So as I said, a relative clause is easy to spot because it always starts with a relative pronoun. And here are some examples of relative pronoun: whose, which, who, that, whom. So have a little look at the following sentences and see if you can spot the relative pronoun in each of them. We went to the new swimming pool, which has three fantastic slides. Josie, who loves to play football, was picked for the provincial team. Sadiq, whose pen had run out, put his hand up to ask for another one. The boy whom you met last week is coming to visit later. My granddad caught the rabbit that had escaped. So if you'd like to, take a couple of seconds to pause your video now, look at those sentences closely and see if you can spot the relative pronoun. Let's go through them now together. Okay, so in the first sentence, which, that is the relative pronoun, and therefore anything that follows it is the relative clause. Who is the relative pronoun? And again, just with a normal subordinate clause that we embed, this is an embedded relative clause. So I have who loves to play football. That's the relative clause. In the third sentence, it's whose. Again, you'll see there the relative clause is embedded and we spot the comma on each end. Whom is the one in the fourth sentence, the boy whom you met last week. And that. My granddad caught the rabbit that had escaped. That had escaped is your relative clause. So where can relative clauses be placed? Well, we've already seen a couple of the bits in that previous slide. So let's just double check that you understand that. So the class were well behaved on the school trip, which made their teacher proud. William, who was wearing his favourite shirt, was going to the party. I go to a swimming club early in the morning, which means that I'm tired by the afternoon. Have you seen the people whom we met yesterday at the park? Amir found the missing cat that his neighbour had lost. Okay, so remember, the first thing you need to do in order to spot the relative clause is look for the relative pronoun. When you found that, what follows is the relative clause, and then you'll be able to see where they can appear in sentences. So let's have a little go. This one is at the end here. Which is my relative pronoun? Which made their teacher proud is the relative clause. So it appears at the end of the sentence in that example. Here, I have an embedded relative clause. Who is my relative pronoun? Who was wearing his favorite shirt? So that one's in the middle of the sentence. So here is the main clause, William was going to the party. And remember, if you need to revise what an independent clause is, you can look at that previous video I made, because an independent clause can stand on its own. Okay, here it appears at the end in the third sentence, which means that I'm tired by the afternoon. In the fourth sentence, can you spot the relative pronoun? It's whom. So there you go. Again, it's at the end. And the last one, the relative pronoun is that. So there we go. It's at the end. Amir found the missing cat that his neighbor had lost. So now let's see if you can create your own sentences that contain a relative clause. So I'm going to show you two pictures. If I can get my mouse to work, where are you? There we go. There's my two pictures. One with some children riding bikes and another with a cat stuck up a tree. And I would like you to take a couple of seconds now, pause the video, and in your workbook, see if you can create two sentences that have an embedded relative clause about each of those pictures. Do that now. Okay, I'm going to show you my examples. I'm sure that yours are much better, but here is my first example. The children, who all wore helmets, were excited about their cycling trip. So again, it's a relative clause. I start with who, which is a relative pronoun. It's embedded in the middle of the sentence, and the independent clause snuggles it. The children, and on the other side, were excited about their cycling trip. That is one clause. It makes perfect sense on its own. The relative clause, I know, begins with a relative pronoun. So it's not just a simple subordinate clause. It's not a conjunction there. And it gives me more information about the children, the noun. Okay, and then the next one. My cat, which was black and white, got stuck up a tree. Here's the embedded relative clause, which was black and white. It tells me extra information, added detail about the cat. And it is in the middle of the sentence. Now, there's one other thing that's quite important when it comes to relative clauses, and that is figuring out if the information you've added is essential or not. Okay, so have a little look at my first sentence. We used it earlier. Josie, who loves to play football, was picked for the provincial team. Now, this information in that relative clause is extra. It's non-essential. So otherwise, in grammar terms, we call it non-restrictive information. And that means that we use commas around it. So Josie, who loves to play football, was picked for the provincial team. We put a comma after Josie and a comma after football because the information is non-essential. It's non-restrictive. In this example here, Amir found the missing cat that his neighbor had lost. That is essential information. Why? Well, because it tells us who the cat belonged to. The cat belonged to Amir's neighbor. Okay, so there's no need to have commas there. We call it restrictive information. Okay, so Amir's found the missing cat that his neighbor had lost. It is essential. It is restrictive. It will not make sense that his neighbor had lost. It really is important that we know that it is about the missing cat. So I'm going to show you a few sentences now. And what I would like you to do is decide if the information in the relative clause is restrictive, which means it's essential, remember, or non-restrictive, which means it's not essential. And if it is restrictive, remember, we don't need any commas. If it isn't, if it's a non-restrictive sentence, then we put commas around it. So let's have a little go and see if you can have a go at these three sentences. Jamie, who is usually late, managed to arrive on time for school today. We went to the best adventure playground, which had a huge climbing wall, while we were on holiday last week. The children did well in the dance show, which made their teacher happy. Okay, so have a look at those three. Is the information restrictive? Remember, which means essential or non-restrictive, non-essential, and decide then if it needs commas or not. The first thing you've got to do is actually spot the relative clause. So remember, keep an eye out for those relative pronouns. Right, let's do the first one together. Jamie, who was late, managed to arrive on time for school today. Well, here's my relative pronoun, who is who. So who is usually late is my relative clause. It is a non-restrictive relative clause, so I'm going to pop a comma and a comma surrounding it. The next one, where's the relative clause? Well, here it starts with the word which. There's my relative pronoun. Which had a huge climbing wall. Is it restrictive or non-restrictive? It's non-restrictive, so we're going to put commas around it. The children did well in the dance show, which made their teacher happy. Well, this is another example of non-restrictive. I'm going to put a comma there. Okay, so let's see if you can do the same with these ones. The prize that I won was a very special signed book. Mia, whose favorite color is orange, was unhappy to be in the green team. Those are the dogs that ran on the grass. Do those sentences require commas because their relative clause is a restrictive one? Have a little go and see if you can figure it out. Okay, so the first one is a restrictive relative clause. That I won is very important. It's essential information, the prize that I won. So I'm not going to put a comma there. How about this sentence here? Well done if you said it's a non-restrictive. It needs commas. Mia, whose favorite color is orange, was unhappy to be in the green team. It's not essential information, okay? So we're going to embed it with commas. And this one, those are the dogs that ran on the grass. That is restrictive, no commas are needed. The information that ran on the grass is essential to the sentence. Now, here is the tricky bit. Do I always need to have a relative pronoun? Well, the answer is no. In a restrictive relative clause, it is possible to remove or omit the relative pronoun if it refers to the object of the sentence and it still makes sense. So here's what I mean by that. Amir found the missing cat that his neighbor had lost. That was the sentence we had earlier. But I could write it as, Amir found the missing cat his neighbor had lost, and remove the relative pronoun that. The sentence will still make sense. So now you have a go. Here are three sentences. Two of them I can remove the relative pronoun from and still make sense. One of them, the relative pronoun, has to be there. So first of all, let's read the three sentences together. The test that we did yesterday was really easy. The class that had the most points was given extra play. The book that I bought yesterday cost me 3 rand. Okay, so one of those sentences I cannot remove the relative pronoun from. The other two I can. Let's first of all decide what is the relative pronoun in those sentences. Well done if you said the word that. So here, here, and here. Now read those sentences through, omitting, taking away the word that, and see if it makes sense. The test that we did yesterday was really easy. The test we did yesterday was really easy. Yes, it works, so I can get rid of the relative pronoun there. The class that had the most points was given extra play. The class had the most points was given extra play. Doesn't work, does it? I need that in there. The book that I bought yesterday cost me 3 rand. The book I bought yesterday cost me 3 rand. Yes, I can remove the that there. So now you really do know a lot about relative clauses. You know that most of them start with a relative pronoun. You know what the relative pronouns are. You know that a relative clause gives you additional information about the noun. And If that information is essential, then we call it restrictive. If it is non-essential, we call it non-restrictive. And that then implies as to where we put commas. So have a little look at here. I am going to have a choice board for you. So I'm going to click on three pictures and you're going to see if you can write relative clause sentences about those pictures, either on your whiteboard, if you've got a whiteboard, or in a notebook, and underline your relative pronoun. Okay, let's have a go. Here we go. It's obviously a teacher and a student who's carrying lots of books. Oh, someone doing a, looks like a scientist doing a science experiment there. And let's go for this one at the bottom. Oh, a beautiful lake with in a valley of mountains. Okay, so your job, see if you can write me three sentences that involve a relative clause about those pictures. And if you can, make sure you underline your relative pronoun. You might even be able to then decide if the information in your relative clause is essential or non-essential, and base that on where you put your commas, if they're needed at all. Right, let's go and now do a quick quiz to see if you can remember everything you've learned. So for each sentence I'm going to give you now, identify the relative pronoun. I can't eat that chocolate bar because it has nuts in it, which I'm allergic to. Mangoes, which are grown in tropical countries, are one of my favourite foods. The cats that were fighting last night kept me awake. Okay, you done? Oh, I forgot one. Silly me. Jamal, who is a fantastic guitarist, has joined the school band. Okay, now let's see if you can pick out the relative pronoun. So in the first sentence, well done, if you said it was which. In the second, another which. In the third, that. And in the fourth, oh, it's who. Sorry, obviously when I added that sentence, it shifted down, but it is supposed to be circling who there. Okay, let's have a go at the second quiz. So I have for you, I lost my mouse now. Can you match the main clause, so remember that's the independent clause, to the appropriate relative clause? So here on one side, I have my main clauses, my independent clauses. On the other, I have my relative clauses, which all start with the relative pronoun. The cat scratched my arm. The pool is full of cold water. I have a sister. The ambulance rushed to help the child. Who is 3 years younger than me? Who had fallen off the jungle gym? Which made it sore? Which is fabulous on this hot day? Can you join the correct relative clause to the correct independent clause so that a sentence would make sense? Okay, let's see how you did. The first one, the cat scratched my arm, which made it sore. The pool is full of cold water, which is fabulous on a hot day. I have a sister who is 3 years younger than me. The ambulance rushed to help the child who had fallen off the jungle gym. Now, I am going to do one last quick quiz with you, which is where I'm going to give you a sentence, and I'd like you to see if you can take out the relative clause, split the sentence into two simple sentences. So this is what I mean by that. Can you break each relative clause sentence back into two simple sentences? I look just like my dad, whose hair is black too. My rabbit, who loves carrots, always runs up to me when I go to its hutch. Mika, whose legs were aching, finally completed the race. So let's have a look at that first sentence. There's my relative clause. And if I want to split it into two, I look just like my dad. His hair is black too. So I take the comma, I make it a full stop, and I remove the relative pronoun. How about the next one? My rabbit always runs up to me when I go to its hutch. It loves carrots. So this time I've taken the embedded clause and I've brought it to the end as a separate simple sentence. Mika, whose legs were aching, finally completed the race. Mika finally completed the race. His legs were aching. Okay, right, so now this time I have got four boxes, but I want you to select the two boxes that show relative pronouns. So which two show relative pronouns? Is it who and which, or bring and unblock? It is who and which. The plumber, who arrived late, had forgotten to bring his plunger, which meant he was unable to unblock our sink. So that sentence actually has two relative clauses in it. Read these two sentences. Rewrite them as one sentence that contain an embedded relative clause. Tawny owls eat mice and other small mammals. Tawny owls are nocturnal birds. Have you done that? This is how it should look. Tawny owls, which are nocturnal birds, eat mice and other small mammals. Or, tawny owls, which eat mice and other small mammals, are nocturnal birds. So remember, you can have it either way. Place commas in the following sentences in the correct positions if they are, obviously, needed based on whether it's a restrictive or a non-restrictive relative clause. Leo, who is very sporty, enjoys PE lessons. I needed there the two commas. The pet ambulance rushed to the injured dog, which had trapped its paw. There we go, a comma there. Right, so let's just recap one last time all of the rules when it comes to relative clauses. Relative clauses give us extra information about a previously mentioned noun or pronoun in a sentence. Okay, and they start with a relative pronoun. GS was going to a fancy dress party. She was dressed as Batman. Becomes Jess, who was going to who was dressed as Batman, was going to a fancy dress party. Okay, so that information is my relative clause. It's extra information. And remember, who is the relative pronoun in this case? And because the extra information in this relative clause is non-essential, it's non-restrictive, we pop commas around it. The relative pronouns that you should always be able to spot are that, who, whom, which, and whose. And remember where in a sentence a relative clause can be. So here, they can be in the middle, in this example, 25 Maple Street, which has been up for sale for years, is apparently haunted. A ghost, whose name is Mr. Stonegarden, roams the corridor. The estate agent, who badly needs a sale, is frightened to show people around. So those are examples of them appearing embedded within the independent clause. Okay. However, remember they can also come at the end. The children who did well in their spelling test, which made their teacher smile. Okay, well, I hope you've learned a little bit more about relative clauses and are able to spot them in other people's work and also use them to enhance your own writing. And I hope to see you again for our next lesson. Have a lovely day further, grade sevens. Bye-bye.